important to you is if, that you succeed in your own country. I mean, could you be happy if you were just big hits over here?
It's more pride, really. You know, everyone wants to make a success in their own country. And as soon as England are ready, we'll be ready. So.
Yeah. Are you guys as tough as your liner notes read? I mean, I read that you guys came out of the East End of London with black eyes and fists flailing. Is that true?
Probably tougher, yeah.
Yeah.
Serious?
Yeah.
Isn't that case?
We fight all the time. We're violently in love.
I didn't mean with each. I didn't mean with each other. But seriously, I mean, was it as tough as I read?
Yeah, I used to be in a street gang. Used to fight all the time, yeah.
Yeah. How do you figure then that the three of you managed to get out of a place that manages to devour hope on a lot of fronts?
That's probably just a case of self-confidence and just doing something that you enjoy doing and hoping that one day, it's like, you know, like the old story of a boxer that, you know, fights his way out of the slums. Well, perhaps we did it by playing music, you know. We just tended to, you know, do what we did, and hopefully, you know, at the end of the day, we come out of it.
You're involved in the business you always wanted to be in. You're making it. Is success what you thought it would be?
The first album was really just to sort of get our feet in the door.
Play deep.
Yeah, first album. And anything above that has been a bonus. I mean, to be able to be useful in industry, you know, for the next 5 years would be great.
What about you, Alan? Is it what you thought?
Probably, it's weird because obviously you have heroes and stuff, and when you're like an up-and-coming band, you look up to them and you envisage what it would be like. Yeah. And because when you actually sort of get there, it's just permanent work. And that you don't realise, you just see the glamour side, you see them on telly or a show or whatever. But it's, you know, there's a lot of art.
But you guys, you say, I mean, isn't it true that, and we were talking about it earlier, I mean, you did a 90-day tour when you were holding down day jobs?
That's right. Yeah, and doing demos in the studio as well.
And doing demos too.
And session work.
What were you doing during the time?
Nothing.
Day
really.
Job. You didn't have a day job.
Officially,
I worked for like the local council, inspecting pipes.
Really? What'd you do?
I used to own the drum store.
Tony?
I was a mail stripper. No, I was a printer.
Still is.
You were what?
Printer.
Oh, a printer.
Yeah.
And you did that while you guys worked also?
Yeah. And I was actually there all the time.
We used to come home from the shows at like 4 a.m. And I usually go straight to work and then bunk off of work.
Yeah. You once disbanded too, right?
Yeah.
Why?
Well, it was a different band. It was different music at the time. We're going back to sort of 1978 or so. And it was like a rock band. And, you know, at that time, we just weren't getting the gigs. Like, the punk thing was happening, and we weren't a punk band.
Yeah.
So we just decided to sort of amicably sort of split up. And but we got back together again about 3 or 4 years later.
Though you're younger than I am, you guys aren't kids. I mean, you're 28, 29.
Well, I'm a kid.
28, 29, and 32. I mean, these days, what do your career ambitions look like?
Go back to working for the council. No, I mean, I suppose I think we all just like fear the band, you know, ending really, because it's, you know, it took such a long while to get where we really are now, that, you know, the thought of it just sort of disbanding would be like a nightmare for all of us.
Yeah. Well, as I say, thank you. I got to ask you at the back end. I mean, the outfield. I mean, what did you think when you finally saw a baseball game?
I don't know. Lot of the hot dogs and the beer.
That was good.
Yeah.
What about on the field?
Don't understand it.
Not at all.
The same way I tried, but
that's all right. I tried to understand cricket. I don't get that either.
So you get the outfield in cricket as well, you see?
Yeah,
cricket's great.
Except for they never do anything in cricket. Tony Lewis, Alan Jackman, John Spinks. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
We're going to come back in just a moment. There's more.